أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم صلى الله تعالى على حبيبه محمد وآله وسلم السلام عليكم and welcome to our segment on Surah Yusuf. Inshallah, today we will cover the 8th Ruku of Surah Yusuf, verses 58 to 68. May Allah grant us the ability to understand the true meanings of the Quran by the grace of His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ameen. With this dua, let's begin the 8th Ruku of Surah Yusuf. Verse 58. And came the brothers of Yusuf. Then they entered upon him. Then he recognized them, and to them he was unknown. This verse continues from where Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam was made a ruler of the land by the mercy of Allah. This verse mentions the meeting of Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam with his brothers. Much time had passed since they last saw each other, and his brothers did not recognize him, who he was, but he knew who they were. Let's go on to verses 59 and 60. And when he had equipped them with their needed equipment, he said, "Bring me a brother of yours from your father. Do you not see that I give full measure and that I am the best of the hosts? But if you do not bring him to me, then there will be no measure for you from me, nor will you come near me." Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam asked his brothers to come back with their younger brother, who wasn't with them, so they can get the full measure of payment for their merchandise. He always gave full measure, and he was a most gracious host. He further told them that if they did not bring him, then they would not get the full payment. We learn about another important character trait of Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam here, that he showed the highest level of hospitality to his guests. We can get an understanding of the relation of the brothers from verse 59. Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam is asking his brothers to bring back a brother from their father's side. This tells us that he was a half-brother to them. As we read further into the surah, we will get more information as to the relation of his relationship to Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam. Let's go on to verses 61 and 62. They said, "We will try to get permission for him from his father, and indeed we will do." And he said to his servants, "Put their merchandise in their saddlebags, so they may recognize it when they go back to their people, that they may return." The brothers reassured Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam that they would get permission from their father and return with their brother. Their merchandise was returned to them to ensure that they would not forget to come back. This guaranteed that they would return. From here, we learn that Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam was sharp-minded and a strategic planner. Let's go on to verses 63 and 64. So when they returned to their father, they said, "O our father, has been withheld to us the measure, so send with us our brother. We will get the measure, and indeed, we will be his guardians." He said, "Should I entrust you with him, except as I entrusted you with his brother before? But Allah is the best guardian, and he is most merciful of the merciful." Their brothers returned to their father and explained why their measure was denied. Prophet Yaqub alayhi salam was reluctant to send their brother, reminding them what happened the last time he entrusted their brother with them, referring to Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam. He then emphasized the fact that Allah is the best guardian and the most merciful, making a point that his trust was in Allah and their brother's protection would remain under Allah and not them. From verse 64, we can get an understanding that the younger brother was the true blood brother of Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam, because he is referred to as his brother and not the others. Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam and his younger brother had the same mother, whereas the other brothers had a different mother. Let's go on to verse 65. And when they opened their baggage, they found their merchandise returned to them. They said, "O our father, what could we desire? This is our merchandise returned to us, and we will get provisions for our family and protect our brother and get an increased load of camels. That is a load easy." The brothers showed Prophet Yaqub alayhi salam the returned merchandise from the king, ensuring to him that they had no ulterior motives. They just wanted to get the payment as promised to them, along with an extra payment for their brother. Let's go on to verse 66. He said, "Never will I send him with you until you give me a promise by Allah that you will bring him to me, unless you should be surrounded." And when they had given their promise, he said, "Allah over what we say is entrusted." Prophet Yaqub alayhi salam made them promise to bring their brother back, entrusting upon Allah the protection of his son. We can see how much faith Prophet Yaqub alayhi salam had in Allah, relying on him for all matters close to his heart. Not everything is always under our control, as much as we would like it to be. Sometimes we just have to let things be and go with the flow, as Prophet Yaqub alayhi salam did, with the utmost faith that Allah is the best of all who we entrust upon. Let's go on to verses 67 and 68. And he said, "O my sons, do not enter from one gate, but enter from different gates. And not I can avail you against Allah anything. The decision is only for Allah. Upon him I put my trust, and upon him let put trust the ones who put trust." And when they entered from where their father had ordered them, it did not avail them against Allah anything except a want within the soul of Yaqub, which he carried out. And indeed, he was a possessor of knowledge because we had taught him. But most of the people do not know. Prophet Yaqub alayhi salam instructed his sons to not enter altogether from one gate. Rather, separate from each other and enter from different gates. Words of wisdom and caution for their protection, so they would not cause unnecessary attention upon themselves, trusting upon Allah for their well-being. This is something we need to be mindful of as well. Life is unpredictable and unplanned circumstances and events happen. We should do our due diligence. Then we should put our trust in Allah in all matters because everything works under His laws. Putting our trust in Allah is known as tawakkul. When a task needs to be done, one should first consult about it before doing it. Then do the task with full determination and diligence, and then leave the result to Allah, trusting in Him for the best outcome. Whether the result is favorable or not, one must accept it as the will and wisdom of Allah. That is tawakkul. When the brothers arrived back to Egypt, they entered from different gates as instructed by their father, putting their father's soul at ease, because he was taught the wisdom of Allah, by Allah, that not all people know. Complete knowledge only belongs to Allah, and He bestows it on whomever He wills. Just as Allah taught Adam the knowledge of the names, and the angels responded, as stated in Surah Al-Baqarah in verse 32, where it says, they replied, "Glory be to you. We have no knowledge except what you have taught us. Indeed, you are the all-knowing, all-wise." This concludes Ruku 8 of Surah Yusuf. Let's briefly go over what we discussed. The brothers of Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam approached him for provisions, not recognizing who he was. They were told to return with their younger brother so they could get the full measure of payment, which they did. Prophet Yaqub alayhi salam was reluctant to send all his sons together on another expedition, but he eventually did, putting his trust in Allah for his sons' protection and then giving guidance to all to safely reach their destination. It is necessary to take precautions in all matters. We must do our due diligence in carrying out all tasks and then leave the results to Allah, because everything runs under His laws and He is the one to put our trust in. May Allah grant us the ability to understand the Holy Quran and its true meanings in light of the life and guidance of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ameen. Thank you for joining us for this segment. Until next time. Sadaqallahu al-aliyyul azim. Allah speaks the truth, the exalted, the great. Sallallahu ta'ala ala habibihi Muhammadin wa alihi wasallam.